Hey y'all, happy Wednesday. Let me get myself in here. I hope this music is not too loud in the background. But anyway, let me pop on real quick to show you my haul from today. Been out in the Memphis streets, kind of hot. Okay, I got a haul from Dollar Tree and IKEA. So let me get in here and tell you what I got. Whenever you're watching this video, I thank you in advance, y'all. I don't got a fly up in here. Oh, Lord. Okay, anyway, whatever. You know it's a complete Jackie show. Hey, y'all, whenever you're watching this video, look, got a haul. So I can go ahead and put this stuff up. I don't know, I'm all over the place, whatever. Whenever you want, computer way over there, I'm right here. Stuff is right here, all over. Anyway, let me get in here. Dollar Tree. I went looking for a particular item. I went looking for one item or to buy multiple of one item, but didn't find none of those, but I found a bunch of other stuff. So let me show you what I was looking for. Is this it? Child, did I even upload? Oh, I think it's here. This is what I was looking for. I was looking for these over-the-counter towel bars. Of course, $1.25. And it's a hack that I was going to use with it. So I'll show you. I'll link a video below of the lady who gave me the idea, but I don't have it with me right now. But she hacked it by, of course, using it over the door. But as you may or may not know, I'm working on my fashion space. And so I'm trying to make use of the space because I have like angled walls. So I got to use the space best I can. But anywho, that's that. So I did find these walls right here. And these are some over the door hooks, but they're not quite the ones I'm looking for because the way I want to hack it, it's like this. So these are the ones that I got. I got a couple of those. Okay. Got those. The first thing I got up in there because it's already hot. I got some water. Okay, this is a Propel. I never had that, but it's zero sugar with electrolytes in it. Do I have this thing? I don't know. Anyway, so I picked up that. I think it's a watermelon flavor. Just a couple more things I got randomly. Fabuloso, and this is the multi-purpose cleaner with the vinegar in it. I haven't tried that, y'all. These nails are beyond janky. Okay, I'm gonna do a DIY, and so I needed some little cups, and so this is what I have. I got these little mini cups, but if you're not following me over on The Creative Lady or on Amazon, that's where I will be doing most of my crafting videos. I am multi-streaming today all over the place, but just FYI for that. What else? Okay, so I found these, and I got several of these because I'm getting ready to do some donating to the Goodwill. So I figured I would need a bunch of these, and I got a bunch. And these are the Essential Brand Heavy Duty Storage Bag. Yeah, so I have never tried these. So it's supposed to store, organize, protect, to transport anything. It's 2 feet by 20 inches. Look at them janky nails, 2 feet by 20 inches. So I figured that's like almost half as tall as me. So it'll put a bunch of stuff in there. So it's the double XL one. Is one bag in there per thingy. And you know, you got a couple. I think these would be good for whether you're storing your summer clothes or winter clothes or whatever. And then, okay, stop a car. Oh, I lied. Y'all, here's some more. I got that many more. Yeah. If I have 5 pairs of pants and 5 shirts and 5 dresses, wouldn't that be fabulous? But that ain't gonna work. But I'm trying to scale down, okay? But yeah, I got this basket because I did not get a shopping cart when I first got in there. And so I just grabbed this cart. I'm like, well, I'll just buy this and put some, I don't know what in it. But anyway, so got that. But then I found these, y'all. I had been seeing them online because I've been watching so many organizational videos and getting inspired and had to run to Dollar Tree. And so I got these. I'm sure y'all have seen it. I'm the last one. These are the Essential Vacuum Storage Bags. I think you put the stuff in there and you take the vacuum cleaner little thing and then you like vacuum close it. So let me tell you what it's supposed to look like. You know, when I get with it, who knows? They're supposed to have a bunch of stuff right there, and then you're supposed to put the vacuum cleaner on it, and then you compact it down. we'll see how that works out. Okay. What else do I have? Okay, show you that show. Oh, here, I want bag right here. Okay. So right here, I got, I'm sorry, y'all. I'm hot. So this heat is raining. Okay. So impulse purchase, everything is just that. Everything in here is impulse purchase. Right now. Oh, okay. So I got these little crafter square squeeze applicator bottles. Now what you gonna do with these? I don't know. But I figured, you know, I'll find a way to use them. And then you can never not have a craft knife, okay? Because when I'm working with the vinyls and everything, I need something to cut, you know, if you cut it or whatever. So I got this, everything in there, $1.25. So yeah, I think I have one of these, but the very time you're looking for it, you can't find it. So I figured, I just go on and get one. And it's got like seven little attachments on it, as long as it cuts, okay? And then I got this, it's like a, it's called a crafter's picker, craft picker. But if you're like weeding your vinyl from your Cricut cut or whatever, you can never have, you can have too many. But I figured, let me just get an extra one to put inside the little Cricut thing. I got a, anyway, I team too much, but yeah, I needed an extra one. So, and then I have been seeing so many people talking about this little, I don't know what to call it. I mean, I've been using the Cricut for so long, but this new stuff, and then they got new tools out. I'm like, what? I'm trying to catch up, y'all. I'm trying to catch up. But they have one thing even here. But this is a, I don't know what this is. Crafter Square Piercing and Scoring Tool Set. I mean, what is this? But I needed it last night. I needed something like this when I was doing a DIY. I was, this is, I'm jumping here, but this is from IKEA. This little, what is it? Canister, something, whatever. A canister, whatever, you know what it is, but you get stuck in it. So I figured I'm working on the, in the closet to, you know, reorganize the pantry, and I put the sugar in like one of these big things. But then the mailman had a good idea. He was like, well, why don't you put a little sugar in like a little container. I was like, oh, okay. So I had a couple of these empty. So I put, look at this janky label, y'all. It was so janky, but I'm like, okay, here's the sugar. I put some sugar in one. I labeled it with my own Cricut. And then I put some accent. I already had a label on it. I think I peeled it off. But I just said, okay, well, let me just try with that one. So I kind of labeled some things last night with the Cricut with this. So I'm like, okay, I'm going to, you know, relabel a bunch of the spices and like the dry goods and stuff. I got these big containers I got from Amazon. I'll link those at the end because I forgot to put them, because I got something else in the description box. Right now, I'll show you that in a second, but I'll put later on my Amazon influencer link for the disclosure. If you make a purchase using my link within 24 hours, I will earn a commission if you know in advance. If you don't, then I'll be cool too. But just showing you and telling you where I got it from. I don't need to trade commission coming for me. For me, Josh. Oh, this is it. This is actually it. So on the end here, on one end, it's got like a little scoring. You can just like, you know, kind of click, you know, to get the stuff off. Like when you ever craft, you know, you put a little sticker on, then you got to scrape it, and then pull off the carrier, you know. So it was kind of hard to make it work because I was using hand tape and not really, you know, what I was going to use. But it was kind of hard to do right. Thank you. So when I saw these, I was like, oh, okay. So these are the things that the girls were using, the boys too, been using these little things here. It says piercing and scoring tool set. Let me just open one to show you what's so nice about this. I don't have to go buy it. They call it a pen or something, but they buy it from somewhere that's really designated as whatever they call it, the pen or whatever. But what it is, it's like a, if you ever use a little picker thing to try to prick it and weed, it's got like a little pen on it. Okay, y'all, whatever. But you see, it's like a little, can you focus on this and not on me? Anyway, it's a pen. And then if you're weeding, meaning you have, you can kind of get the little extra weeding stuff out. That is supposed to be so easy, but I see right here, the cap is falling all off, child. Because I was already trying to figure out how can I hack that and make it myself. But now I don't have to because I done rumbled and stumbled up into the Dollar Tree and got a couple of them. But yeah, you know she probably too because they were twins. No, she lying. So then I saw these, y'all. Laser cut craft icons, okay? I got these, and I got pairs. They're the same. I got two of them. I thought they were the same. They look similar. Quarter. Anyway, I figured I might put some duck rings in them and make some earrings out of them. What? So I was like, well, let me just get a couple of pairs. I have to, you know, they really turn out right. Really, y'all want a pair. Okay, so I got a couple of those. And then, what else? Oh. Like I said, rearranging the colors in my the crafting space is pink, black, and white. I think it's hot pink, like double gum pink, black, and white, and yellow. All those colors. But you know, once you put it together, it's all right. So I got this other little space that I need, like a smaller, what is it, storage container. So I think it's kind of tiny. Let me open it up and show it to you. Because it's not as big because the little space that I need to put it in. I got two of them. The space is not that big, but the little storage thingy is small. So I figured, well, let me just get this one. And, you know, I'll get two just in case. Because I needed a place. This is what it's supposed to look like. I needed a place to put my the heat press. If you follow me over on Amazon, I did a live a couple weeks ago with the day was prime day or prime time, something like that on Amazon. And I had the cocoa butter and craft supply thing going on. And so I heat press live a show that said cocoa butter and cabin supply. I love it. So this is what it looks like, the little bin. It's a lot smaller than like the one you might get at Walmart or even IKEA. So I'm hoping that it'll fit in there. It's got like a little pool thing. It feels very budget, but it will functionally serve for, you know, having all these tools in. Okay. So, matter of fact, let's go ahead and put it to use right now for the crafting. Put that in here. Okay, all the little bitty craft items. Okay, I think I have about two or three. Okay, seems too much. I think we have got too many. But yeah, this is the original thing, the pick thing. And then, so now you can use it with, you know, with this kind. So anyway, it's like a... okay, so, you know your girl been trying to expand the crafting reach. And so I was using, I'm sublimating now. Okay, hey Gwen, like something from another mister that made me come off. I've been trying to use the sublimation ever since. Child, it was 2020 when everybody was at home and everybody was sublimating and converting their Epson 7720 into a sublimation printer. But you know, she was like, couldn't get nothing. But anyway, so I finally got everything and finally got another printer. You know, which I thought was coming. But I finally got the sublimation printer that I want or converted one. Anyway, so I saw these. And these are satin pillowcases. And they are 20 inches by 30. I think it's probably the size of like a full size or just a regular pillow. But you know, we're going to open one. And this is reminding me of Spider-Man. I don't know. When I saw this, right? And so I don't know if I'm going to be able to do anything on this or not. But it was just too cute to not get because the mats in my car kind of go with it. And anyway, we haven't seen it. Anyway, it's this color. Anyway, it's a red, red, channel, what kind of. But anyway, yes, I got these. I don't know, I might end up sleeping on them, but not these. But these right here, very, this is what I really saw when I saw these. I did not go in there looking for sublimation materials. You go in there, it's like, oh. I've been watching videos and then they go to the Dollar Tree and you can find sublimation blanks on here. What? That just sounds so complex, don't it? All you need is some polyester. And it don't even tell you what kind of fabric it is. It says satin pillowcase. Okay, satin. It's satin polyester. Try it. I don't know, but we're going to try it and see. And then when I look at the back, it said, it's 20 by 30, of course. And it says silky satin material. Silky satin material. It don't say that it's polyester. But, you know, you need a high, it feels like it might be polyester. Let me see what this one is made of. Look at them put it on the outside of the package. They know what they're doing. It says in here, look at them Jack and Dale child. Hold on, y'all. Let me see if this thing's on the right thing. Hold the line. Hold on, y'all. Mode. Why is it not on the right? I don't know. Whatever. Anyway, so it does say. Oh, I think it's up. It does say 100%. It says 100% polyester. It don't zoom in. It'll pick these janky nails up. Anyway, it does say 100% polyester. So, with that, I was hoping. So, I got these. That's for these light colored ones to be able to sublimate on. I don't know what I'm going to put on, but I bought a few of them in case it works. You know what I'm saying? I can have a matching sublimated. So anyway, we're going to try that. But then again, I was also thinking I can use this for fabric or something else. And I'm going to sell it for a pillowcase because I've been wanting to test sublimation on some different things. You know, testing if the colors look right or whatever. So I bought these to, test those. What else? I think that's almost everything I got, except I'm just like a little kid getting out the store. They got me with the pool stuff, you know. I'm like, okay, what else did I get? And I got old lady gum child, big red. I love like cinnamon disc. I love big red gum, like that cinnamon flavor. Oh, I love it. So I got two of those because it's almost time for me to go back to work. Oh, disrespectful, so disrespectful. And then I got some this kind of extra cola. The peppermint, but I like the peppermint. And then I saw these. I was thinking about something like this. I'm old, you know what I'm saying? So as a kid, I had like candies like this. And so I got these with the caramel cream, the original caramel filled with cream. They're so good. It's like nuts. But if you don't need to be eating that, don't eat that. Okay. And then, this is what I really was thinking about, because as a kid, I had something called a slow coat or something, like black or something. But I saw these, I'm like, okay, Cowtail, original caramel, Cowtail mini, so I got those. So I think that might be everything from Dollar Tree. Yep, I think I showed you everything. So let me show what I got from IKEA. So I roamed on over to the IKEA. And then here's what I was looking for, because I did a hack. Is this it? Okay, yeah. So I got these headboards the other day when I went to IKEA. I didn't film it again because it was too hot. Ooh, it was smoking out there, smoky. And so I picked up a black pegboard. And what I did is, you'll see over to the right, the left side is the black pegboard. And this is what people normally do with it, is put, you know, the pegs in it, and then they'll hang some of the IKEA, you know, furnishing on it for keys or for other, whatever you want to put on it. But watch another video, because I was like, how can I hack this, you know? And what I did was I took one of the black pegboards that I had from the other day. This particular one to the right, it says I hack storage for IKEA cart. This is not the Raspberry, but I got two of the Raspberry cards. But I forgot what this one is called. But anyway, I'm going to take this one upstairs. Right now, it's in the kitchen. It's got like food items on it. But I'm going to take this one back upstairs and put the Raspberry card over on the side by the countertop because of what else, the other thing I got that I'm going to show you. But anyway, so I took some zip ties and I zip tied the the pegboard, child. It's hot. I zip tied the pegboard to the cart, okay, so that I can then put some, what you call them things like hooks or whatever in it, right? Okay, I know this thing too much. Look to the right, and that's what I got. And so that's what I bought today. Some extra pegboard, you know, anyway, it's called, you know what it's called, gauges. That's the brand right there for the pegboard. So I got the 14 by 22 because my space for this part is narrow. They got some wider ones, like 22 by 22, but I knew that I needed the slender one to fit the side of the cart so that I can zip tie it on. So the mailman thought, oh, you're such a genius. I was like, okay. But anywho, so shout out to the fellow crafters, the creatives who are just, you know, helping push you over to realize, yeah, that's what I was trying to come up with or how to figure out how to do it. So at the end, I'll try to go back and link that video. That's just a couple of them. She didn't even speak English. Her video was for the caption. All I did was just watch what she was saying. And then every other, watch what she was doing. Every other word I heard was IKEA. I'll link her video below because it was truly an inspirational video to show me. She had put her cart together. I didn't have to put the cart together. I already had two RevCog carts, and then I had like another little cart over here. So I was like, okay, I'm halfway there. All I need to do is find some zip ties and chow. The mailman had some zip ties, and he done had some chow. Bob was a cook, okay? And so I didn't have to wait because I ordered something. I'm not going out to the store. It's too hot. It's 100. So the heat index is probably like 150 outside. It was just hot. And you know, my little car is like this. I'm sandwiched near the asphalt. Some beating. Child, it was hot out there. But anyway, so these are the, what are they called? Oh, it still ain't got no name on it. Look, this is what that little thing is called. IKEA 365. IHOP, child, whatever that is. Salt shaker, pepper shaker, whatever. Anyway, so I got two of these. So that I can decant a lot of the spices. If you watch my last video live on Amazon, I think I took it down, made it private for here because it was just not the channel for cooking or whatever. So anyway, if you saw it, I have this little Lazy Susan spin around thing. But yeah, so these are the ones that's in here. Four of them, they're like $3.99, I think, for four. About $3.99 for four. And so what I like about this, it's got like the pour side, and then it's got the shaker side. So that's what I really like, the shaker side. So the mailman put a little salt on his whatever, not salt, child, sugar. The heat, I don't know, the vapors out there, child. Okay, so the sugar that I put in my coffee or whatever, it'll just be easy, okay? So I got two of those. I told you I got two. What else? It's something else. I can't even find it. It's right here. I think that's all the things I got from IKEA. I got two of those. I got some more of the. Oh! What the thing is? Now, hold on. I'm sorry. Okay. Whew. I was trying to take a wager with y'all before I went live to see if the mailman was going to come home before I got finished with the live. But, child, he done beat me home before I can even go live. He was. I was like, yo, salmon. It's so impeccable. But yes, I got two of those. I buy those big containers of like smoked paprika and lemon pepper and I know I had a whole other container. Oh, here it is. I'm not finished. The heat. I've already ticket ticket boom, but the heat, child. Okay, so I bought extra of those little, whatever these things are, containers to put from like the accent, the lemon pepper, smoked paprika, pink Himalayan salt. But I found this, because let me show you, hold on y'all, pardon me. Sorry y'all, the noise. But see, I got this giant container of pink Himalayan salt, right? But I like to grind it up because I don't always want to break out the little mortar and pestle thing. I'm like, but the one I got has black pepper in it. And so I saw this. What is it called? There's no kind of name on this thing. Whatever. But I think this is a pepper grinder. But I figured I could put, you know, the pink Himalayan salt blocks in there. And that should, you know, do it for me when I'm cooking. So I picked up this thing too. I think I had one already, but I had been putting my cooking utensils in this, and I'm like, this thing is glass. Oh, I need to get this out of here. So when I actually went to IKEA, I figured, okay, let me get one of these, and this is what it's designated for. What is it called? So let me show you. Look for yourself. That's what it's called. ORDENING. The Scandinavian word style. Ooh, I don't know. Ordaining. Whatever. This thing right here, container to put your utensils in, like the little things that you want on the countertop when you're stirring and serving and scooping, you know what I'm saying? So I've got one of these, but I think it's down underneath here. Whew. Okay, oh, inside here. So I bought a bunch of these because when I went Saturday, who goes to IKEA on a Saturday? Ooh, you know, that's my favorite time to go to IKEA to see how the out-of-towners figure out how they're going to get all this stuff and the baby bassinet in the car because they done over-purchased everything and it came in the wrong kind of car. Yeah, they're trying to make life decisions out there in the parking lot at IKEA on the Saturday. But I was able to scoot in there and get exactly what I want and get out in less than 15 minutes. So on a Saturday, that's a deal. So I couldn't find these Saturday because that aisle was packed. So these are some little accessories that go to the pegboard, and this is like some little, I think you put it in there, like a little paper clip child for the pegboard, but let me just show you how it looks. You just have to go in there wrong and type in pegboard and then put the accessory for it, but it's just like a metal paper clip. Okay. Got the little thing in here that will fit inside the pegboard, but then if you want to put your papers or whatever on there, and the craft installation, whatever. So I got that. It's cool in that pack. And then I bought a bunch of hooks because I figured with all these pegboards, I'm gonna need a bunch of hooks. So each pack comes with two of the hooks or whatever. But this is what it is, and it's got, I don't know how to figure it out because I have never owned an IKEA pegboard. And I bought a bunch, okay? They were inexpensive. Like, you know, IKEA has great prices. Oh, and then let me show you a couple more things. Let me get this, but this is an empty box, child. Listen, I love tubes, okay? Love it, because that's where I find out a lot of things. This is what I bought that I really discovered. I forgot what video that was, but it was somebody who was talking about this, I think. This is a, what is it called, y'all? A hog maw. What? Hog maw? What is a hog maw? Hog maw? Something. H-O-G-S-M-A. Okay. So what this does, if you've ever heard of the Rad Cog cart by IKEA, just look on my R-A-S-K-O-G. It's a cart that you've been on YouTube any amount of time looking at crafting videos. It's like a little storage cart. Yeah. But this becomes, you can put it on top of the cart, and then it doubles as like a cutting space or whatever. And so that's why I'm gonna put the Rad Cog back to in the kitchen, so that if I'm doing a cooking video, maybe if it fits in a snuggly and doesn't fall in, then it'll like have extra space when I'm doing a video or whatever. Because I've been doing more cooking videos, but that's more than I have been doing. So yeah, this little thing here, it fits into the cart. So yeah, it's wooden. Yep. So I'm excited to try this. So that's why I decided to hijack the Rad Cog. Okay, so watching videos on Sunday, I was watching Miss Diva, like, you know, Kiki and her husband Steve, and they are just so fun, y'all. I just love that they live in Miami. And so she was talking about these things right here called, I'm crunched up the box, child, for recycling, because I got childish. But pardon the box, but this is called Island Way Sorbet with a Touch of Cream. And she talked about these handmade fruit sorbets, and then they come with multiples in a pack. I thought, I never had them. So some TikTok made it pop, but I don't do TikTok like that. But he had 10. I'm like, how did I get 12 in this one? But anyway, so I'm like, who got them? So I was on a mission to find them. Sam didn't have them, so I saw that Costco had them. And so, child, I went and I signed up for a Costco card because we use Costco, but then we stopped. And so now that I'm breaking up with HelloFresh again, we boxed everything out and beat up so bad. I don't know, like, whatever, then the recipes that didn't match it, but the food is delicious, but it's like new. So anyway, Costco had the recipe. And so I didn't want to go out of Utah, so I reactivated, I found my password for DoorDash. What is it called? It's a good green carrot on it. What is that name? Instacart. I've only used it once before. And so, I hope y'all can hear them. But anyway, I just couldn't look. But anyway, so they got coconut, heavenly coconut, ruby berry, ruby grapefruit. I guess it's like a combo. I haven't had that. Did I eat that? Well, I think I ate that one. Wait, that was good. The heavenly coconut is the bomb, y'all. And then the passionate mango and the zesty pomegranate. Let me tell you, that thing was so good. I was like, girl, let me order me some. So I got these and a couple other things. But let me show you, if you haven't seen it, did I throw the one? Here it is. The heavenly coconut one comes in like this little hand-packed coconut shell. I was like, I'm gonna wash this out and use it for storage. Can I throw this one? But it just seemed like to keep, I didn't keep the orange piece. Okay, but anyway, so I kept that. Then I figured it was cute. I like that. I could use it for something. And the other thing, if you were on my Amazon Live with me, I have my Amazon link, child. Let me see. When I go live on Amazon, here it is. I do have a link from somewhere. So that's my Amazon shop. Like when I go live and stuff, or post things that I purchase, because everything that I post, I love. So you don't see me post anything if things that I purchase with my own money. I had one item sent to me, and that was, if you were on the live, it was a KitchenAid attachment, which is probably the thing you're supposed to use. But yeah, so I got that. And that was it. But for everything else, I'm trying to my own. But I was telling y'all about the charcuterie board, child. I don't know anybody is charcuterie. And so doing Amazon Prime, I purchased a four times, y'all. I couldn't wait. I wanted to have me a charcuterie board because let me tell you what I saw with it. I was watching my guilty pleasure, Real Housewives of Atlanta, and this might have been a couple of weeks ago. Kenya had somebody over, Sonia, Daniel, whatever her name is. She ain't one of my favorites, but she is a flip-flopper. But anyway, so she had made a charcuterie board. I was like, okay. And of course, well, she showed the brand name because Kenya is an Amazon influencer and Kenya is a smart businesswoman. And she was also, time I was on Wendy, she was one of the guests. So I have this special place for Kenya Moore. Even though, I love her personality. Lately, because since she's had our daughter, she's been so much more considerate and not the mean girl, But I like Kenya more this time. But anyway, so Kenya had a charcuterie. Child cheese board. Okay. And I showed y'all that live. But anyway, so it has ideas for the charcuterie. And so that's, I had to use it because I haven't had time to have really. The items that I purchased to put on the charcuterie, child, we ate up without even being on the charcuterie because we were hungry. It was like, I need a snack. I'm the heck out of the charcuterie thing. I'm going to put it on the charcuterie. Okay. Child, this might be bad. Can I get in here? Hold on, no. What are we doing here? Anyway, so I bought a bunch. I bought some cheese. I bought some grapes in there. I'm going to get in here. Oh, boy. See, look. Dang, I don't even have time. We can do it, y'all. I bought some stuff to try to do the charcuterie. I did. I bought this little cup. I'm going to have to wait. Look at this. It didn't look good when I bought it. But I get. Oh, y'all, hold on. I'm sorry about this Amazon thing. I'm trying to find somebody. But anyway, so I bought this little snack pack. It's like veggies, chips, and guacamole. July 14th. What's today? Oh, child, throw this away. Throw this out. That's how long I've had it, okay? But might just do it for the core, not right. But yeah. So I had bought this, put on a charcuterie, and then I got some cheese, and then I had some grapes. So these are, well, they didn't look good when I bought them. But if you know me, you know I love the cotton candy grapes. Okay, these, they were so tiny, but you know, they're like anything. They were like little bitty marbles. I'm used to the cotton candy grapes being about so big. If you never had them, when you find a good batch, they taste just like cotton candy. I don't know how they do it. Now, I got these locally at a store called Sprouts. It's like a farmer's market type store. I've shopped there before. I've done video hauls stuff in here. But I've seen them at, I've heard you can get them at Kroger. You got a Food Lion, Giant, I don't know, Kroger, Walmart. I have never seen them at Walmart because I have only been to Walmart a couple of times since the pandemonium started. Yeah. So anyway, here's my charcuterie. It comes with two little, it comes with two little containers for you to put different sauces or whatever, make the guacamole, but you're not going to do that for the old child. But it comes with like this little set right here where you can put your, I think, food or whatever you want to put on, depending on who you're entertaining, because you ain't doing the entertaining, but you know, it was cute. Okay, and then it comes with the big board. Like if you were gonna do something like big. But it's heavy too, and the brand is, I'll show you. But anyway, this is what Kenya had. Why did it ain't got it? Well, the one Kenya had a smaller on it. I didn't even notice. It ain't even branded like the one she had. But anyway, I couldn't figure out how to get whatever. I couldn't. But it's heavy. It is plenty heavy. Try that. Anyway, it ain't got smiley on it nowhere. Whatever. Anyway, so it has this one where you can put like the, I haven't washed it off, but you know. So put the two little containers right there. You're going to put however you want to do it. To put your crackers or your whatever you want to just. It's heavy too, guys. You got a bad copper tongue like this old lady. Whew. Anyway, inside here, some kind of way I haven't figured out how to use it. It opens up to the little oven thingy, like the place. Like you have pickles and olives or whatever you want. You don't want to pay people just grab it with their hands. They've got the little thing. Let me see if I can show you a picture. Okay, here's the brand right here. I'm pretty sure that's the brand. That's the brand Smiley, whatever. And see how nice that look? It just feeds your body and your soul. Yeah, I was inspired. See, I got grapes and stuff and cheese board. Now, it gives you some tips on how to, you know, cheese plate pairings and essentials or whatever. You know, they show you like the cheese and stuff and the sauces and meats and vehicle. Oh, I guess if you put it on. Child, this is just too fancy. Call me the vehicle. Okay, I guess what you put it on, like when you stick the stuff down and child, whatever. I don't know. Hey, Auntie. But so I couldn't resist. I had to have this. I wanted it. Now, mind you, every Super Bowl, I have these type of things. I have a glass one, then I got one that's plastic that's shaped like a football. It's got little compartments in it, but I figured, let me elevate my style. Attention. You mean to be. Okay. Now, I think that's everything, y'all. I think that is everything. Yep. And if it ain't, it's going to be too bad for me because I'm done. I need to get out of here. I'm hot and I'm hungry. And I thank you for watching. And we're going to get on about it. Oh, come on, left comment. Who over here? Luana! Hey, Luana! Luana, wait, come on. Okay, hey, sis, I ain't taking HelloFresh back no matter how many. Yeah, ain't they trying to? They got me. I had broke up with them. I had busted up with HelloFresh. Now the food was delicious. But the boxes, I mean, I can't show it to you because I have loaded it with stuff to put in the trash can. Try my recipe cards. Come on, let me show you. Look at the car. It don't make a difference. It don't matter. But and then they keep sending. Okay, listen. yeah. Okay, so I didn't see these. If you want some HelloFresh coupons, I got about 6 of them. Anybody, whoever is ever watching this video in the next 30 days, because I think they expire. The girl got HelloFresh coupons. I got 3 of them. So if you out there, just let me know, and then we'll find a way to send you the code. Now, the way it works is you might, I don't remember because I've been using them so long. You might get a credit card, even though it's free. Sometimes it might be like you have to pay for shipping. Shipping might be like $8.99, but the boxes and the food is delicious. But I've just been, you know, everybody's been on this great resignation thing. And so maybe it ain't the same. People used to pack it when I was getting them in the pandemonium. But look at these cards, y'all. I mean, they just been slapping the stuff in there. Okay, the card. I'm sorry, LaJuan. Let me move this for a second. But yeah, girl, I understand. They got me because I have nothing. They finally got me again. But look at this. The card all smooshed up. Okay? And it was just terrible. I mean, and then the box was all busted open. I don't know if they picked it up. It's the shipping. You know, Fred X. Probably delivering and what the box is trying to bottle all sitting out in the sun hot. It's been a mess. Sometimes the recipe card would be wrong. I would have the bag. Let me show you. I got this. Okay, this is right here. This is a cheesy smothered mushroom chicken. Okay. Now, this right here. So this is correct. Okay. So this is what I'm gonna cook in a little while. But so hopefully the ingredients are right, because what happened lately, I would go into the bag and it's the wrong stuff in there. I guess it looks right. Yeah, this looks like the right stuff. I mean, it looks like it's got the carrots and the stuff. But I had like, if they had, wow, it's just been so wrong. Broccoli in there, but it's gonna be something else. And I'm like, yeah. And I love HelloFresh. I think it's just, they are hiring, because I keep looking on the pack, it says they're hiring. So, you know, everybody's resigning from their job. Not everybody, but a lot of people are changing careers, and who wants to do this? Who wants to do that? Who wants to teach? I'm kidding. But, you know, everybody's just looking at their life and making it through the 2020 and realizing, man, I don't want to do this no more. So even people packing groceries, they don't want to do this. So they can just throw anything up there. And then they can just put the groceries in. Look. I'm sorry, y'all. I bought some orange juice. I'm going to make me some. You put the orange juice with the Seco, whatever it's called. It's like lemon. But you know. But yeah, it's just sometimes just the quality of it. The food is delicious. If you get the right ingredients that go with the car and you cook it, it's delicious. If you can cook, it might slow you down a little bit because it is very step by step. Like, okay, do this. While you're doing this, do this. It's like you on a episode of Chopped, okay? Anybody can cook with this, okay? You can be a non-cooker, it's gonna get you there. But I find myself doing it my own way, but trying to use everything that they send. But it's just something just been off, okay? But it's still a wonderful service. It got us through the pandemonium, because we wasn't going out in the stores, you know what I'm saying? So it got us through. But I just kind of go through periods of I'm breaking up with them. So anyway, I think that's everything. So thank you, LaJuana. Thank you, everybody who has watched me, because I do have a subscriber only on. So you know, when I go live, child, I'm so old, trying to get up in here and be doing all kinds of crazy stuff. So I'm like, for my apologies if you wanted to come in and can't. Child, it's a control thing, because the trolls are crazy. But yeah, if you got a BJ's, or if you got Costco, I'm not sure who else might have them, but so get y'all some of these right here. These are Island Way sorbet. Something delicious. Okay, I think that's everything. And if you supported me today, I appreciate you. If you supported me during Prime Day, thank you very much. I appreciate everybody. You don't have to do anything, but just do you, okay? And I appreciate you popping. Alrighty, y'all. Let me find my way over here and get up out of here, because I still am all over the place. So you know, I'm gonna get out of here. It's always, I can't. One day I'm gonna get all of my stuff set up where I can just push a button, but when is that gonna be? I don't know. But anywho, let me show y'all. I saw this thing here. This is a pendant light, okay? So it's called a Grimsus. I hope I spelled it correctly, but it's called a Grimsus pendant light. And that thing captivated me. I want one in every room. So I took a picture of it, and yeah, child, she got legs, child. She was up in there taking pictures. I didn't have a shopping cart until, like, I got around. My strategy for going into IKEA is to go in, don't get a buggy, don't get a cart until you get to, like, into the marketplace, and then you get a cart. But these items that I purchased, like the cutting board, was before or after I passed the cart over, child. But yeah, this is a beautiful pendant light. Now, I don't know who's gonna hang it up, because neither one of us fools around no electricity. So yeah, so that, and what else? I showed y'all. Yeah, I think I showed y'all everything. But anywho, we are going to get all the way out of here, and I will see y'all in another video. Love you to the moon and back. Subscribe if you're interested, and we are out of here. All right, love you. Bye, y'all.